Hello, and welcome to I Learn English. My name is Jed, and I will be your tour guide of the English language. In this lesson, we will be talking about the future progressive. First, I will explain it in English. E depois, eu explico em português. So, let's get started. Okay, so the future progressive. First, we'll talk about how it's used, its formation, affirmatives and negatives, question formation, and then some final thoughts. The first thing I put on this slide is to just be aware that native speakers don't follow the technical rules very strictly for the future progressive, even less so than the future simple. Technically, it's used for an action that will be in progress at a specific time in the future, such as they will be having Italian for dinner tomorrow night, or they will be discussing important information at the meeting, she will be arriving at 10:30, they are going to be traveling to Russia next summer, I'm going to be really busy tomorrow. So that's how it's used. So let's talk about formation in the future progressive. There are two ways you can form a sentence in the future progressive. The first way is by using will, and then be, and then a present participle, which you remember is a base form followed by ing, or by using be going to, followed by be, followed by a present participle. And I know that sounds like kind of a lot, and so we're going to explain it in a little more detail. Let's look at the first formation with will, and then be, and then a present participle. She will be having a party this Friday night. They will be traveling all of next month. Okay, that's the first way you can form a sentence in the future progressive. The second way you can do it is with be going to, followed by be, followed by a present participle, such as, I am going to be having lunch with my friend on Sunday. She is going to be leaving after the meeting. And finally, they are going to be starting the project soon. So these are the two ways that you can form sentences in the future progressive. With this slide, I just wanted to remind people that it is possible to use the future progressive without a present participle. And really always, that's the rule with to be. So here are some examples. I will be really busy at that time tomorrow. I'm going to be really busy at that time tomorrow. Exact same meaning. So just two different ways of saying the same thing, which native speakers do all the time with the future progressive. Next example, she will be very tired when she arrives tomorrow night. Doesn't have a participle. Again, they are going to be angry when they hear the news. No participle. They will be unavailable from 10 to 11. So just so you know, it's possible to use the present progressive without a participle. Let's talk about affirmatives and negatives. And affirmatives and negatives can be formed by simply putting not after the auxiliary verb. Let's take a look at some examples. They will be having a meeting. They will not be having a meeting. She will be discussing HR. She will not be discussing HR. You will be visiting your cousin. You will not be visiting your cousin. I am going to be traveling. I'm not going to be traveling. She is going to be working all day. She is not going to be working all day. They're going to be taking a test. They're not going to be taking a test. So for the future progressive, all you have to do is insert not after the auxiliary verb. To form a question in the future progressive, all you have to do is switch the order of the subject and the auxiliary verb. Sound familiar? The companies will be working together. Will the companies be working together? She will be arriving around 10:30. Will she be arriving at around 10:30? It will be hot next week. Will it be hot next week? The kids will be playing at lunch. Will the kids be playing at lunch? Everyone is going to be working. Is everyone going to be working? You're going to be tired tomorrow. Are you going to be tired tomorrow? So again, all we have to do here is switch the position of the subject and the auxiliary verb. And some final thoughts on the future progressive. It's used to express an action that will be happening at a certain time in the future. Follows the same logic and principles as the future simple. It does not have to be followed by a present participle, but it often is. Negatives just add not after the auxiliary verb, and questions just need to switch the position of the subject and auxiliary verb. Thank you so much for watching this class. I hope it helped explain the future progressive a little more to you and that you understand it a little better. If you have any other thoughts, questions, ideas, suggestions, just type them in the comment box and I'll be happy to respond. And now we will continue in Portuguese. Oi, gente. Vamos falar sobre o future progressive. Então, ações que vão ficar em progresso num tempo no futuro. Vamos falar sobre como usar, formação, afirmativos e negativos, formação de perguntas e, finalmente, algumas ideias principais. Os usos. Primeiro, eu quero falar, eu falei no Future Simple que os native speakers usam will e be going to sem pensar e é até pior com o progressivo, que a gente só usa o que entra a cabeça. Mas lembra que a gente usa para ações que serão em progresso num tempo no futuro. Vamos falar primeiro um pouquinho sobre como usar. Native speakers nem seguem muito as regras. E se você já assistiu a aula sobre o Future Simple, fica até pior no Future Progressive, que a gente simplesmente usamos o que entra a cabeça. Mas o uso técnico é para ações que serão em progressos, num tempo no futuro. We will be having Italian for dinner tomorrow night. They will be discussing important information at the meeting. She will be arriving at 10:30. They are going to be traveling to Russia next summer. I'm going to be really busy tomorrow. A formação do futuro progressivo. A formação. O futuro progressivo, você forma com o will, e depois be, e depois present participle, ou be going to, e depois be, e depois present participle. Eu sei que parece complicado, mas na verdade, fica parecido ao português, ou pelo menos rima com português. A formação do future progressive pode formar ou com will, e depois be, e depois present participle, ou be going to, depois be, e depois present participle. E eu sei que parece complicado, mas pelo menos rima com português. Primeiro, will mais be mais present participle. She will be having a party this Friday night. They will be traveling all of next month. E eu não sei, geralmente quando eu falo português, eu uso essa formação, tipo, estarei fazendo blá blá blá. Não sei se essa segunda formação existe em português, que é be going to mais be mais present participle. E como eu nunca fiz aulas, eu não sei se existe. Mas existe em inglês, e vamos dar uma olhada. I am going to be having lunch with my friend on Sunday. She is going to be leaving after the meeting. They are going to be starting the project soon. Pode usar essa formação no futuro progressivo em inglês. Pode. Então, tem duas formações, igual ao future simple. E como você pode ver, fica mais ou menos parecido ou mais ou menos igual. Só para você saber, é possível formar uma sentença no futuro progressivo sem o present participle. Por exemplo, e sempre pode com to be. I will be really busy at that time tomorrow. I'm going to be really busy at that time tomorrow. Mesma coisa. She will be very tired when she arrives tomorrow night. They are going to be angry when they hear this news. They will be unavailable from 10 to 11. Então, só para você saber, é possível formar uma sentença no futuro progressivo sem present participle. Ok, vamos falar sobre afirmativos e negativos. Para formar um negativo no futuro progressivo, Simplesmente tem que botar not depois do auxiliary verb. Então, they will be having a meeting. They will not be having a meeting. She will be discussing HR. She will not be discussing HR. You will be visiting your cousin. You will not be visiting your cousin. I am going to be traveling. I'm not going to be traveling. She is going to be working all day. She is not going to be working all day. They are going to be taking a test. They're not going to be taking a test. Então, para formar os negativos, só tem que botar not depois do auxiliary verb. Tranquilo. Vamos falar sobre formação de perguntas. E para formar uma pergunta, só tem que trocar a posição do sujeito e o auxiliary verb. The companies will be working together. Will the companies be working together? She will be arriving around 10:30. Will she be arriving around 10:30? It will be hot next week. Will it be hot next week? The kids will be playing at lunch. Will the kids be playing at lunch? Everyone is going to be working. Is everyone going to be working? You are going to be tired tomorrow. Are you going to be tired tomorrow? Então, só tem que trocar a posição do sujeito e o auxiliary verb e pode formar uma pergunta. E alguns final thoughts para encerrar. O futuro progressivo se usa para expressar uma ação que será acontecendo num tempo específico no futuro. E geralmente segue as mesmas regras e lógico que o future simple. Não tem que ser um present participle no final, mas é bem comum. Os negativos só tem que botar not depois do auxiliary verb. E as perguntas só tem que trocar a posição do sujeito e auxiliary verb. Muito obrigado, gente. Eu espero que ajudou. Qualquer dúvida pode entrar em contato comigo no comment box e vamos ficar em contato. Boa sorte e bons estudos!